Hello everyone, welcome to the video class on immunity and immunosuppressants. In this video, I am going to explain about innate versus adaptive immunity, immune cells, humoral immunity and cell mediated immunity, and finally I will explain about immunosuppressants. Recently my channel has crossed 1800 subscribers. Thank you for the subscribers. If you like the video contents, do subscribe. This is my channel. Let's get into the class. Now, there are broadly two different immunity types are there. And they are known as innate immunity and adaptive immunity. Innate means inborn. That means when human beings are born, they are gifted with immunity. Immunity means the ability to resist infection. So this is the means by which we resist infections. And this is conferred during the birth, and that is known as innate immunity. The other one is adaptive immunity. Adaptive immunity will develop when human beings grow up. It is adaptive to that infection, hence it is known as adaptive immunity. We'll see in detail about these things, but let us understand the differences between these two branches. One, the innate immunity will show action immediately. Whenever human beings are affected with any infection, immediately the innate immunity starts showing its effect. But it is non-specific. That means it is not very specific to a particular infection. It will be acting broadly. The other thing, it doesn't has any memory. See, these are the major features of innate immunity. It acts immediately. It is not specific. It doesn't has memory. Whereas adaptive immunity, it takes some time to develop. It is not immediately acting, and it is very specific. It is very specific to a particular pathogen, and the best thing is it has got memory. Now, based on this thing, vaccines are developed. Because of this memory, vaccines are developed. We'll see them in detail. Now, when you see the differences again between innate and adaptive immunity, see, innate immunity is already present in the body. You don't develop, you just have it during the birth itself. Whereas adaptive immunity is created response to exposure to a foreign substance. When we grow up, we will be exposed to a lot of kind of foreign substances and pathogens. Then this immunity is developed. Now, as I told you, innate immunity is non-specific, whereas adaptive is very specific. The response is rapid in case of innate, whereas adaptive, it takes at least 1 to 2 weeks to develop. Now, potency, it is limited with lower potency, whereas adaptive is highly potent. Memory, there is no memory with innate immunity, but adaptive immunity has got long-term memory. Now, there are no allergic reactions because of innate immunity, but adaptive immunity sometimes may cause allergic reactions and hypersensitivity. The excessive action of adaptive immunity is what results in autoimmune diseases as well as hypersensitivity reactions. Move on to the next one. Now, so we have seen there are two types, adaptive immunity and innate immunity. Innate immunity by birth will have it. Now, adaptive immunity again is classified as natural and artificial. Natural means, see, it could be again two types, passive and active. Now let us understand this thing. See, passive immunity is from maternal or from the mother. Certain antibodies, immune mediators, can cross placenta and get into the baby's blood system. So passively immunity is passing, and it is called as passive natural adaptive immunity. Not only that, even mother's milk contain IgM, IgG and IgA antibodies. All of them will pass through the mother's milk. So both of them are passing passively to the kid. So it is known as passive natural adaptive immunity. Whereas the other one is active natural immunity. When human beings are exposed to infections, they develop immunity. So this is called as active form of infection. So these two comes under natural adaptive immunity. Whereas the other fragment is artificial, artificially increasing immunity. How? Passive means antibody transfer. In certain people, when infection is very high, antibodies are developed and they are directly given to the human beings. So this is passively increasing immunity. Whereas active immunity, stimulating human being immune system is possible with immunization. These are nothing but vaccines. This is how vaccines work. So again, immunity is classified as adaptive and innate. In adaptive, you have natural and artificial. In this, you have these things are there. To make it clear, look at this. adaptive immunity you have naturally acquired and artificially acquired. Naturally acquired, you have active is there, passive is there. Active, see, naturally when you get infection, antigens enter the body and they will trigger the production of antibodies and other immune system. So see, this is one of the reason why kids, young children need to get infected. When they are exposed to infection, their immunity develops and that is what gives them good immunity. Now the next one is passive one. Passive, naturally acquired. Naturally, few antibodies pass from mother to fetus through placenta passively. So this is what is called as passive, naturally acquired immunity. Now the next fragment is artificially acquired immunity. In this, the active means antigens are introduced into the body through vaccines to trigger immune response. So what, see, vaccines are either weakened pathogens or dead pathogens. Once they are introduced into the body, they activate, they trigger immune response in human beings. It is a form of active, artificially acquired. Artificially you are giving a vaccine. The next one is passive one. In this passive one, preformed antibodies in immune serum are introduced by injections. So directly antibodies are given. So this is called as passive. So this is the distinction between naturally acquired and artificially acquired adaptive immunity. Moving to the further now. Excuse me. So these are different kind of immune cells. So we have seen till now what type of immunity is there, innate and adaptive. Now immune cells in innate immunity are basophils, eosinophils, neutrophils, mast cell, natural killer cells, and there is a system called as complement system. All of them comes under innate immunity. Macrophage and dendritic cells are also considered as immunity, but they form a bridge between these two system, innate and adaptive immunity. When you see adaptive immunity, you have two cells are there, B cells and T cells. B cells will be secreting antibodies. These two comes under adaptive immunity. Now look at this time of response. Within hours, innate immunity will act, but it takes some days to start adaptive immunity. In fact, see, the innate immunity starts with the physical barrier like skin and mucous membrane. They are called as first line of defense. So if any infection, when the skin is intact, it cannot cause any infection. When the skin is ruptured or wounded, then there is a chance of infection. Even our mucous membrane forms a very, very good physical barrier for all infections. So once these two are breached, then when the pathogen gets into the blood or cells, these cells will start showing action. Now what happens is, the initially innate immunity will kick in to show its actions, but later on, it is activating adaptive immunity. When the infection is normal one with low potency or short term one, innate immunity can control that. If infection is going for chronic periods, then adaptive immunity will start and shows its action. Now, to give you a clear picture, let us see what all the white blood cells are. White blood cells are classified as granulocytes, agranulocytes. The cells has got granules. You can see small granules are there. Because of this presence of granules, they are considered as granulocytes. You have neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils. Now see, neutrophils are phagocyte, they phagocyte bacteria and other pathogens, and they are the immediate mediators. Whenever someone gets an infection, immediately neutrophils start showing their action. Eosinophils, they control mechanism associated with allergy. Now basophils, they contain histamine and heparin. In fact, the names are derived because of their chemical nature. Basophil has got basic molecules, whereas eosinophil has got acidic molecules. Neutrophils, they are neutral in charge, neutral in this thing. So they are called as neutrophils. Now see, basophils, they release histamines. Now the next part is agranulocytes. You cannot see any granules inside them. So they are considered as agranulocytes. You have monocytes and lymphocytes are there. Now these are all the types of white blood cells. To give you a comparison, so the total blood cells are these things. You have red blood cells and platelets are there, and then white blood cells like basophils, neutrophils, eosinophils, monocytes, lymphocytes. So these are all the overall blood cells in human body. Now again, so to give you a clear picture, see, this is a hemopoietic stem cell. This is known as HSC cell. This is what gives origin to all immune cells. At one side you have myeloid progenitor, another side you have lymphoid progenitor. From myeloid progenitor you will get all the cells, neutrophils, basophils, eosinophils, monocytes are developed into macrophages and dendritic cells. Along with that, you have mast cell also there. Now, the other one is natural killer cells. So all these are comes under innate immune system. So our innate immune system has got all these things. You have granulocytes are there. Granulocytes, as I told you, you have neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils, and then you have monocyte is there. Monocyte, and then natural killer cells are there. All these cells are parts of innate immune system. So these cells will try to counter all the infections. They take the help of complement system. Complement system is made up of plasma proteins. Around 30 plasma proteins are there. They have wide variety of actions. They will lyse all the pathogens with the help of all these cells. So all these cells comes under immune system. Whereas in case of adaptive immune system, you have only two cells are there. The lymphoid progenitor will be giving a B cell and a T cell. So basically you have two cell types are there, B cell and T cell. Both of them comes under adaptive immune system. Now B cells can develop into a plasma cell or develop into a memory cell. So I have explained at the beginning, the adaptive immune system has got memory. This is what is this. Similarly, T cell can give a memory cell, cytotoxic cell or helper T cell. So all these things are types of T cells. So you can see from T cell, you will get T helper cell, T cytotoxic cell and a T memory cell is there. Whereas B cell, you have a B plasma cell and B memory cells are there. You can see both the adaptive system has got memory cells. Memory means when the same pathogen causes second time an infection, these cells will immediately show an immediate action because they have memorized the pathogen with the first attack. When the same pathogen attacks second time, these memory cells will act immediately. This is how vaccines are developed. So this chart will tell you what all the cells of immune system. Moving further, see, in innate immunity, the innate immunity mediators are granulocytes. Among them, the neutrophils are the major one. When someone gets infection, the first cell of defense is neutrophil. See, neutrophil will be circulating in the blood. Whenever it finds some infection, it attaches with the endothelial cells and move to the site of infection, and this process is called as chemotaxis. They go and engulf this microorganism. That process is called as phagocytosis, and they will kill the cell and they also undergo apoptosis. So at the site of infection, the pus what we see is because of neutrophils. So these are all the first line of defense which will come and attack the microorganism and phagocytize. They eat away the microorganism and kill them, and after that they will also die. Apoptosis means programmed cell death, and that is what comes out as pus. These are the important innate immunity mediators. Now the other things like NK, natural killer cells are there. See, natural killer are cytotoxic against cancer cells and viral infected cell. When the cell has developed certain virus and cancer, the cell cannot be repaired or become normal. In such instances, NK cells will come and destroy this cell. So cyto means cell, toxicity means toxicity. It causes cytotoxicity and kill the cells. So this is NK cells. Whereas monocytes, I have already explained you, they can develop into dendritic cells, macrophage or osteoclast. See, monocytes are usually moving in blood circulation. They will get into the tissues and get converted into macrophages, dendritic cells and osteoclasts. So they, in fact, they form bridge. They are like a bridge cells between innate and adaptive immunity. Now, coming to the adaptive immunity, we have seen the cells. The major cells are T cells and B cells. Now you need to understand lymphocytes. What are lymphocytes? See, lymphocytes are nothing but T cells and B cells. The reason why they are called as lymph is T cells and B cells will move through blood as well as lymph. Because they are moving through the lymph, they are called as lymphocytes. Now when you see the lymphatic system, in the lymphatic system you have lymphatic vessel, tissues and organs are there. Now they are considered as primary lymphoid organs and secondary lymphoid organs. In primary lymphoid organs, the T cell and B cell development and growth occurs. We have two primary lymphoid organs are there, thymus and bone marrow. Thymus is above on the heart, bone marrow inside the bone you have this bone marrow. Now from the bone marrow, B cells are developed. The B derived from bone marrow, whereas from the thymus, T cells are derived. The T is derived from thymus gland. Now, secondary organs, at these secondary organs, the developed B cells and T cells will encounter a pathogen. So the interaction of pathogen with B cell and T cell occurs at secondary lymphoid organs like lymph nodes, spleen, mucosa associated lymphoid tissues, tonsils and all of them. So this is about lymphatic system. Let me explain it again. So this is a major part in adaptive immunity. Lymphocytes are T cells and B cells. Because they are moving through the lymph, they are considered as lymphocytes. Now, you have lymphatic vessels are there. Understand what is lymph. See, when the blood is passing through the blood vessels, some of the plasma will be leaking through these blood vessels. And this white color fluid is known as lymph. And this lymph will be moving through the lymphatic vessels. See, the drain of interstitial fluid or lymph from peripheral tissues into the blood. So what happens is whatever this plasma is collected, again it will be going to the blood. Now in this lymph, you have T cells and B cells are there. See, the reason why lymphatic system is developed is, you can see in this diagram, the green color dots in the vessels indicates lymph. So the lymph always will be having T cell and B cell. Their job is they will continuously circulate to check for pathogens. If any pathogen is there, they will start an immune response. Now organs, you have primary lymphoid organs and secondary lymphoid organs are there. In primary, thymus and bone marrow are there. See, in the bone marrow, both B cells and T cells will develop, but the complete development of T cells occurs in thymus. In bone marrow, the B cells will completely develop. Now after the development, they will be moving through this lymph and they will be getting into these secondary lymphoid organs like lymph nodes, spleen, MALT, mucosa associated lymphoid tissue and tonsils, wherein the interaction with pathogen occurs. So these are all the fragments of adaptive immune system. Now look at this. This is a bone. In the bone marrow, you have a common lymphoid progenitor cells are there, from which you develop both the T cell progenitor and B cell progenitor. So you have a developing B cell and developing T cell are there. The T cell will get into the thymus, where the complete development of T cell occurs, whereas B cells, they develop in bone marrow itself. Now they will be released into lymph, hence they are known as lymphocytes. Cyte means cell, lymph means they are present in lymph. Once they get exposed to antigen, and exposure to antigen occurs at secondary lymphoid organs, they will get activated. Once they are activated, they release activated T lymphocytes, and activated B cell is known as plasma cell, which secretes antibody. Now, the lymphocyte will be giving plasma cell an antibody. This is known as humoral immunity. Humoral means body fluid. The reason why it is called as humoral immunity is these antibodies are released into body fluids like blood. That is why it is known as humoral immunity. Whereas T cell, as such, the cell is activated and will be conferring immunity. Hence, it is known as cell mediated immunity. So basically, in adaptive immunity, you have immune cells are T cells and B cells. The B cell conferred immunity is known as humoral immunity. The T cell given immunity is known as cell mediated immunity. Humoral means body fluid. All these antibodies will be releasing into body fluids. Hence, it is known as humoral immunity. Whereas T cells directly will give some amount the immunity, and this is known as cell mediated immunity. Moving to the next one. See, this is again a comparison. See, in innate immunity, when the microbe comes, the first line of defense is skin, epithelial barriers, and then mucous membrane. If the microbe can cross and gets inside the body, the first line of defense from white blood cells is phagocytes. They come and they try to engulf the microorganism. So simultaneously, the activation of complement system occurs. And the NK cells also will start showing their action. And this happens within hours. As we have seen, the major cells are granulocytes, NK cells, monocytes, and then complement system. Whereas in case of adaptive immunity, it is because of B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. Now B lymphocyte developed one is known as humoral immunity. The reason is once it gets activated, it will be releasing antibodies. So it is released in body fluids, hence it is known as humoral immunity. Whereas in case of T lymphocytes, the T lymphocytes will get activated and the cells itself will show actions. Because of this, it is known as cell mediated immunity. Now, see, B lymphocytes can directly interact with a pathogen and show immunity. Whereas in case of T lymphocytes, they need presentation of this antigen. It is done by a specific cell called as antigen presenting cell. They are known as APC. We'll see about them in detail. Now, let us see how it occurs, humoral immunity. In case of B cell activation, the virus, see, virus or organism, it comes there and it is directly interacted with a B cell. See, the virus particles, the antigens will directly interact with the B cell. The B cell development occurs and it will be developing into plasma cell and memory cell. Plasma cell will be releasing antibodies, whereas this memory cell will remain inside the body, and when the same virus attacks second time, these memory cells will mount a higher amount of immune response. See, when you see the complete actions of B cell or humoral immunity, these are all the functions and actions of humoral immunity. A microorganism will come, attaches with a B cell, and the B cell activation and differentiation occurs. It will be releasing all these antibodies into the circulation. Along with that, you have memory B cell is also there. When you see the functions, the effector function, the B cells will neutralize, or antibodies neutralize microbes and toxins. See, they will be releasing these antibodies, they will combine with microorganisms and they will neutralize them. Second one, opsonization and phagocytosis. Understand this word, opsonization. See, this is a process by which immune cells can recognize pathogens. Imagine you have a pathogen like this. The B cells will come and attach with this. Once it is attached, a big phagocytes will recognize it and neutralize this one, or phagocyte this one. So this is what happens. See, this is the pathogen. The antibodies will bind with that. Once antibodies are bound with that, the phagocyte can recognize and kill this entire microorganism. So this happens when antibody binds with this pathogen, and that process is called as opsonization. So opsonins are bridge between an antigen and this antibody or phagocytes. Now the next one is antibody dependent cytotoxicity. Directly the antibody can cause cytotoxicity. Now the next one is antibodies can activate complement system. Complement system, they cause lysis of microbes, phagocytosis of microbes, and they also cause inflammation. So these are all the functions and the actions of humoral immunity: neutralization, opsonization, antibody dependent cytotoxicity, and complement activation. Now let us say about cell mediated immunity. See, cell mediated immunity, a T cell will be there. As I explained, there is something called as antigen presenting cell, like dendritic cells, B cells, and monocytes can act as antigen presenting cell. That means the antigens are presented on the surface of this cell. Look at this. This foreign protein is nothing but antigen. That means when a microorganism comes, it will be lysed inside the cell and the proteins are expressed on the surface. This is what is the protein, the foreign protein. When this protein is there, T cell can recognize that protein along with co-stimulatory signals. Like adhesion proteins, T cell gets activated. Now this antigen protein is expressed with the help of a protein called as MHC protein, major histocompatibility. MHC means. Nowadays it is also known as human leukocyte receptor. So this MHC proteins, you have two types are there, MHC1 and MHC2. Now MHC1 proteins are present in all type of the nucleated cells, but MHC2 are only present on antigen presenting cells. Now see, let us see the role of antigen presenting cells. See, they phagocytosis the antigen. So this is an antigen which is lysed here. The fusion of lysosome and phagosome, enzymes start to degrade the pathogen. They broke the pathogen into small fragments. See, it got into the cell, it combines with this lysozyme, and with the help of lysozyme it breaks into small fragments, and these small fragments, the fragments of antigen, are presented on antigen presenting cell surface. So these fragments, with the help of these MHC receptors, are present on this surface. Leftover fragments are released by exocytosis. So this is important. Unless this presentation is there, T cells cannot act. So this is the major difference between B cell and T cell. B cell can directly combine with pathogens and neutralize them, whereas T cells requires the help of antigen presenting cells. Now see the entire action. See, dendritic cell is one of the type of antigen presenting cell. So on the surface it has got these antigens. Once it is there, the T cells will get activated. There are two populations are there, CD4 and CD8. Now CD4 cell will be binding with MHC2 type of receptor, whereas CD8 will bind with MHC1 type of receptors. So once this antigen presenting cell activates the T cell, they will be proliferated into CD4 and CD8 cells. Once they are activated, they will be released into blood circulation. They will be migrating, and the CD4 cell will cause phagocytosis of microorganisms. The other thing, they cause the release of cytokines. Now cytokines are major immune chemomediators. They activate B cells. See, CD4 cells are also known as helper T cells. The reason is they activate B cells too. So we read it as a different systems, but it goes together. Without the help of CD4 cells, B cell activation will not occur. So the cytokine causes inflammation and macrophage activation. Whereas CD8 cells they act on cells which are infected with microorganisms which are present inside the cell. Microorganism is already present inside the cell, and their job is to kill that cell. So that is the reason why CD8 cells are known as cytotoxic cells. So basically you have two populations are there, T helper cells and T cytotoxic cells. T helper cells will be binding with MHC2, whereas T cytotoxic cell will be binding with MHC1. And the activation occurs only with antigen presenting cells, and this is how they activate. T helper cells will be releasing cytokines, as well as they will activate inflammation and macrophage, whereas CD8 cells will kill the cell. They are cytotoxic cells. Again, see, when they are developed, they will be releasing effector cell as well as memory cell. The uniqueness of adaptive immunity is memory cell. So when the same organism attacks for the second time, these memory cells will immediately act. They don't need further activation. They are already present inside. So they multiply and immediately act on that pathogen. So this is what is memory. So again, the important cells and their activation in the immune system, look at them. See, B lymphocyte, it can directly recognize an antigen like microbes, and it releases antibodies and activates complement system. So the function is, it will be neutralizing microbe, it causes phagocytosis, and it causes complement activation. Now the second one, T helper cells, they need the help of antigen presenting cells. Once they recognize them, again the multiplication occurs, they also release cytokines, and it results in activation of macrophages, it results in inflammation, and it causes proliferation and differentiation of T and B lymphocytes. This is important one. Understand this. This is the reason why, you know, HIV virus will attack T helper cells. So it will be affecting both the development of T and B lymphocytes. The next one is cytotoxic T lymphocytes. Now cytotoxic T lymphocytes, they attack infected cell presenting with microbial antigen. They bind with the cell and they cause killing of the infected cell. That is why it is known as cytotoxic. You have another class of cell is there known as regulatory T lymphocyte. This is required for suppressing immune response, and this is the reason why when this system fails, people will get autoimmune diseases. So the suppressor cells is required so that the immune system will not attack our own cells. So they are called as regulatory T lymphocytes. And finally, this is an innate immunity mediator, natural killer cells. It also binds with the cell, either virus infected or cancer cell, and it kills the infected cell. So this is about immunity. So if you have any doubt, please go through it again, take the screenshots of the slides. Now let us see about immunosuppressants. Now immunosuppression is required during organ transplantation. When someone has got liver or kidney transplantation, you are transplanting another person's organ into a human being. So that is considered as foreign. So what happens is the receiver body immune system will start attacking this liver or kidney. So to avoid that, immunosuppressants has to be used. The other use of immunosuppressant is during autoimmune diseases. Autoimmunity means when our own immune cells start attacking our own organs. To control that also, immunosuppressants has to be used. Let us see about them. See, there are four major classes are there: glucocorticoids, calcineurin inhibitors, anti-proliferative, anti-metabolite agents, and biologicals. Understand them. See, glucocorticoids has got major immunosuppressing action. Calcineurin is an intermediate which is required for activation of T cell. Now, anti-proliferative anti-metabolite agent means all these T cells and B cells will undergo proliferation to give immune mediators. When the proliferation is inhibited, T cell, B cell number is reduced and the action is reduced. The last one is biologicals. We'll see them one by one. Now, Let us see the mechanism of action. See, glucocorticoids will be acting on elements known as glucocorticoid response elements, which are present on DNA. And they bind with the DNA, cause DNA activation, and releases certain mediators which will reduce immunity. This is what is the mechanism of action. Whereas cyclosporine tacrolimus, both of them will be acting, they inhibit calcineurin. As I told you, calcineurin is required for T cell activation. This results in reduced T cell activation. If T cell activation is reduced, both T and B cell activation is reduced. Now the next one, azathioprine, mycophenolate, mofetil, both of them are anti-proliferative agents. They will reduce DNA proliferation. See, cell proliferation occurs when DNA multiple copies are produced. When DNA proliferation is reduced, cell proliferation will not be there and immunity reduces. Now, sirolimus, everolimus, they inhibit mTOR. See, this particular protein is again responsible for cell multiplication in immune cells, and that mTOR is reduced, mammalian target of rapamycin, the name is, and that is required for the development or multiplication of immune cells. Now, see, these two, belatacept, alemtuzumab, they inhibit co-stimulatory ligands. Now, understand this, this is an important one. T cell activation occurs with the help of antigen presenting cell, right? Antigen presenting cells will present on their MHC complex, these proteins will be presented. But in order to activate T cell, it needs a co-stimulation also. The co-stimulation, when it is inhibited, immune response is reduced. And these drugs act in that manner. Again, the muromanab, daclizumab, basiliximab, all of them will be blocking particular receptors. T cell receptor is blocked by muromanab. Interleukin 2 receptor is blocked by daclizumab and basiliximab. Let us see with a diagram. See, this is a typical antigen presenting cell. Now understand this one. See, this is an antigen which is presented with the help of major histocompatibility complex. Now along with that, these are called as co-receptors. So this is a T cell. Look at this. This is a T cell. So the T cell receptors binds with this major histocompatibility complex, and these co-receptors also bind with these receptors. So co-receptors are essential to get activity. Once this binding is occurred, the protein kinase is activated, which activates this calcineurin, and finally it increases gene transcription, results in the release of all the cytokines, interleukin, interferon, tumor necrosis factors. Similarly, the interleukin 2 receptor is also present on T cell. The activation of this occurs with the help of mTOR, and this also increases gene transcription, translation, and all these intermediates. So basically what happens is, once this receptor is activated, these are the important process. Gene transcription and translation results in all the cytokine release. And the important mediators are calcineurin, mTOR. The important receptors are these receptors, T cell receptor as well as these co-receptors. So this is about T cell activation. Now look at each and everything. Say muromanab, it will be blocking this T cell receptor. Whereas abatacept, belatacept, daclizumab, basiliximab, they are blocking co-receptor activation. I told you the T cell activation occurs only with the activation of co-receptors. If these are blocked, activation will not be there. Whereas alemtuzumab will be blocking CD52 receptor. Now this cycloserine tacrolimus inhibitors are there. Cyclosporine tacrolimus will be inhibiting calcineurin, whereas sirolimus will be inhibiting mTOR activation. Mycophenolate, mofetil, azathioprine, they inhibit nucleotide synthesis. If this is inhibited, the multiple cell lines of T cell and B cell will not form. Now T cell differentiation and all of them occurs with these mediators, and tumor necrosis factor activation is inhibited by infliximab, adalizumab, etanercept. So these are all the drugs and their target of action, site of action. Let me give you a list. So this is what happens. An antigen, when it gets into major histocompatibility complex with the help of antigen presenting cells, T cell receptor activation occurs. T cell receptor activation causes calcineurin activation. It removes a phosphate group from NFAT, and that results in interleukin 2 gene promotion, and interleukin 2 is produced, interleukin 2 receptors are produced, cell cycle is activated, cell proliferation occurs. These are all the various steps. Now every step is inhibited by a particular agent. See, these two drugs, anti-thymocyte globulins and muromanab, will inhibit antigen activation of T cell. See, they cause destruction of T lymphocyte. The adverse effects, see the last one, this one is adverse effects. Now the adverse effects are profound immunosuppression, fever, chills, cytokine release syndrome. See, basically the T cell activation is completely inhibited, which will result in profound immunosuppression. And because the complete T cell suppression is there, suddenly the cytokine amount will increases, and that is called cytokine release syndrome. The next one, see the calcineurin inhibitors are cyclosporin and tacrolimus. They block calcineurin and inhibits interleukin-2 synthesis. And what happens? They may cause nephrotoxicity, neurotoxicity, hepatotoxicity, hypertension, hyperlipidemia, hyperkalemia. All these adverse effects are there. And tacrolimus may also cause diabetes. Now, finally, interleukin-2 receptor activation is inhibited by basiliximab. It blocks interleukin-2 receptor. It causes gastrointestinal side effects. The next one, sirolimus, everolimus, they will be blocking again interleukin-2 receptor activation. See, for all these things, you need to look at this one. mTOR activity is reduced by sirolimus and everolimus. So they block cytokine-stimulated cell proliferation. They will also cause hyperlipidemia, thrombocytopenia, leukopenia, headache, all the side effects. Now finally, azathioprine, mycophenolate, mofetil, they inhibit cell proliferation. They inhibit purine synthesis. So because purine synthesis is inhibited, they may cause bone marrow suppression, hepatotoxicity, anemia, and neoplasia too. Mycophenolate may cause GA upset, nausea, diarrhea, and increases susceptibility to infection. So this is an important slide. Take a screenshot and put it on the paper so that you will remember everything. So these two things, this is where the site of action, this diagram will give you what are the sites, where do the drugs act, and this will give mechanism of action, adverse effects, and everything. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, do subscribe.